Today I wanted to talk about probiotics. What are the benefits of probiotics? What are the side effects? And who should take probiotics? Hey guys, my name is Dr. Sam. A few of you recently asked me to make a video on probiotics. What a fabulous topic. There is quite a bit to cover, so I thought I'd try to give you a broad overview on probiotics and discuss some of the latest research on it. If you're interested in something more specific around probiotics, please hit me up in the comments and I'll try to make a more targeted video for you. Firstly, what are probiotics and where do you get them from? Well, probiotics are medicines, food that has been fermented, or food supplements that contain beneficial bacteria for our gut. Actually, your own gut contains about 100 trillion microorganisms with a combined weight of about 1 kilogram or 2.2 pounds. Probiotics are being added to some foods such as yogurts, and they are also available as capsules, tablets, sachets and sprays. I'll link all the best foods that contain probiotics in the description for you. Why does your body need probiotics? This question takes me back to my first year in medical school, where we had a slightly eccentric professor who would go on and on about probiotics and how helpful they are to our bodies. And at the time, I'll admit I was a skeptical 18-year-old and I didn't believe him. Now I feel really foolish because there is an avalanche of evidence about the benefits. Essentially, probiotics increase the numbers of healthy organisms in your gut and reduce the number of bacteria that could be harmful. They have four broad actions on the gut. The first one is that they strengthen the barrier in the gut to harmful substances. Secondly, they stimulate the immune system in the gut. Thirdly, they lessen the amount of inflammation in the gut. And finally, they help digest and absorb nutrients. Research has shown that our gut microbiome can be thrown off balance by a number of factors, including medications, especially antibiotics, too much alcohol, stress, poor sleep or disease. This means the good bacteria that work well within our bodies may reduce in number, which allows more bad bacteria to take over. Harmful bacteria have been linked with several conditions, including obesity, heart disease, allergies, and cancer. So what conditions have probiotics proven to benefit? Well, the first one is diarrhea from antibiotics, and this has been well established that taking probiotics whilst on antibiotics can prevent antibiotic-associated diarrhea in both children and adults. This has also been shown for nasty infections like Clostridium difficile as well. Irritable bowel syndrome. Probiotics are an effective treatment for IBS, especially lactobacillus and bifidobacterium. Coughs and colds for toddlers in preschools and nurseries. A particular kind of probiotic called lactic acid bacteria has been shown to help. And infantile colic. Probiotics cannot stop it, but it can reduce the daily crying time when using LAB, which is something to consider at 3 o'clock in the morning. What conditions are a probiotic maybe? Well, recurrent urine infections, studies have been mixed, but a benefit can't be ruled out. Secondly, bacterial vaginosis and vaginal thrush have unclear results as well. Thirdly, eczema. Unfortunately, in large studies, probiotic strains make little or no difference in improving eczema symptoms. But on the flip side, there aren't any increased side effects or adverse problems from using probiotics. And then there's Crohn's and ulcerative colitis. They've also shown quite mixed results with using probiotics, but I wouldn't exclude it entirely. So what conditions are a hard no for probiotics, meaning no evidence? Okay, so premature labor. Unfortunately, taking probiotics in pregnancy has not shown to decrease or lessen the risk of premature labor. Weight loss, again, so disappointing. But there isn't enough evidence to say that probiotics help people lose weight. And the same goes for colon cancer, but probiotics are helpful with some of the side effects, especially from radiotherapy. So what are the risks of taking probiotics? Well, there haven't been any specific studies looking at the safety of probiotics, but in general, they are considered to be safe, except when someone is critically ill or when used in premature babies. There is still the risk of allergy to probiotics, which is the same risk you'd have to any other food or medicine. One of the criticisms leveled at probiotic medications is that the products may not contain the actual strain of microbe that they're supposed to contain, that the quantities of live microbes are too low or too weak to have an effect, and potentially they may contain harmful microbes. I still feel that these risks are very low in the general scheme of things. So, should you start probiotic supplements? Okay, the million-dollar question. I guess the answer to this depends on what condition you are trying to treat and which probiotic you want to use. I really don't have a problem with people choosing to use probiotics, but just maybe let your doctor know that you're taking them. And additionally, I think pharmacists are very helpful at advising you on the best probiotic for your particular condition. From my personal opinion, I'm a big fan of trying to get things naturally into our bodies through diet. So if you aren't sure, I'd start with dietary forms of probiotics and go from there. Please give this video a like if you found it helpful and hit the subscribe button for new videos every single week and hit the bell to get notified when I post new videos on Tuesdays. Please let me know in the comments what you enjoyed about this video or what you would like to learn more about. I've just started posting on other platforms like BitChute and Library. If you prefer to watch me there, please go and take a look. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you again soon.